Hey, what's up, people? Today we're going to be drawing Gaara from Naruto Shippuden, so the Kazekage of Naruto. But yeah, basically you can see that I've started off with a square which is 7 centimeters in diameter. Is that right? 7 centimeters in length and height, and I've divided that square into 4. Into quarters, and we're going to use that so that we can draw a more accurate circle, as I've done in the past with my previous video, the Chibi Metroid, I think it was. But basically, we're just drawing in this circle first so that we can get the basic shape of the head, and then we can move. Well, we can get the circle to work off of to make the basic shape of the head, and then after that we're gonna, like, once we've got this circle done, we're just gonna jump into time lapse and get the basic shape of the head done, and we can start moving on to the body. But yeah, basically it's just trying to draw Gaara in a cool pose. Never drawn Gaara before or done any drawings associated with Naruto before, really. So I thought that it'd be pretty cool because, like, Gaara's a pretty cool character in Naruto, and I know that I'm not pronouncing Naruto right, but I don't feel that anyone except for Japanese people could pronounce it right, because if you pronounce it the Japanese way, it's just going to sound silly because I have a weird English voice instead. So, I mean, this is just me drawing that line for the base of the chin, which we're going to work off of to get the rest of the face done. So I'm just going to jump into time-lapse now so that I can get the outline of the chin done, and, like, get a fair outline of the head done as well. So I'll get that sorted now. So you can't really see what I did to the head there, really, but I've got the basic shape of the head itself sorted, which you'll see later on. But for now, I'm just getting in a parallel line to the chin for his, like, where his shoulders are going to be, because in the pose that he's going to be, it's more like his one arm is lower than the other, because his other one is just, like, going to be reaching out at you. So this is just going to be his collar now that I'm drawing in, which is just, like, basically two straight lines parallel to each other again. They're going to reach up to hit where his neck is going to be momentarily. So I'm just getting that line in there for his neck. And then we can start to branch off and make the collar, which is, again, going to be parallel to that shoulder line that we originally drew in. So we can just branch that down now so that it joins that shoulder line, so that we've got a fair representation of the colour, which is just this easy to draw rectangle, really. You don't really need to see me do this in too much detail. We're going to add wrinkles to it later in time lapse for when we get into the details and stuff, but as for now, we've just got his colour in, and we can start to move off and draw some of the shoulder lines in a bit, like, a bit more easier to see. So I mean, now that we've got the colour in properly, it's more defined, I can start to add in the shoulder lines on each side. So I've got the one on the left hand side, or his right, so we're going to move on to the one on the right hand side, or his left. So by doing the shoulder lines, we can start to work out where his actual chest is going to go, and I'm just drawing in these two parallel lines now that link to each of those shoulder lines, just going off at a bit of an angle, because in this pose he's going to be leaning back slightly. I mean, it's not going to be, like, drastically, like he's falling over. It's going to be more like the weight of the gourd holding him back a bit, that kind of thing. I mean, it's not actually going to be the weight of the gourd that's pulling him back, but you get what I mean. The angle isn't going to be too crazy. So I mean, now I can start to get a bit more of the shape of his actual cloth, that clothing underneath, by following those initial parallel lines that I drew in. But I mean, now that I've got those in, I can start to draw the basic shape of his body. So I'm just going to get that done now, and then I can come back and, like, show some of the add some of the details to his clothing. So I'll just get the basic shape done. So, I mean, I got through quite a bit there. Added his hand. I didn't think it was necessary to show you that due to the fact that I don't think I'd be able to do it in real time anytime soon, because it's quite a hard thing to do, like a hand reaching out. In all fairness, I can't teach that because I don't even know how I drew it. It was literally just trial and error, just messing about until the angle seemed about right. So, I mean, we're going to focus on more of the important things by drawing in these easy to draw rectangles, just so that we can get in some of those details. I mean, you can see that I added the wrinkles to his collar, his under clothing as well, like the wrinkles on his shirt, like the shirt sleeve, the jumper sleeve kind of thing. And you can see me adding the wrinkles now as well, just to the back where these straps that are on that like body armor kind of clothing, like pulling against the cloth, causing those wrinkles to be made. Generally, that's it. I mean, you just got to think about where these wrinkles are going to fall, really, and just try not to add too much. I've added quite a few to the shirt sleeve, which probably there's probably more than necessary there, but I've just put them in there anyway because you just pretty much I just keep adding until it looks like there's enough there without it looking like it's gonna look crazy, like he's never ironed his shirt since he bought it from a junkyard? I don't know. Wherever you can buy wrinkly clothes from, I don't think there is a place, but junkyards are where I would go for wrinkly clothes if I were to wear them. But yeah, so I mean, I've started to get those straps in, and I mean, those straps actually hook like into the inside of that body armor. So you'll see in a bit me adding the actual belt buckle strap thing that like locks it all into place in the front in a bit, and that's just where it's going to pop out from underneath the armor and like tie it all together. But yeah, I mean, it's just about getting the basic shapes again. I mean, these straps are basically just rectangles, and I mean, those belt buckles are going to run off of, like, where those straps have fallen. You can just draw an arc over to the other side, like a slightly curving line that just it runs parallel to the bottom of his body armor, pretty much. And because you just got to think about where this strap itself is going to fall. It's going to run along the same kind of path. It's going to go to the contour of his body. So I mean, we can add in basically just a basic curve, curving line across there to find out where these belt buckle straps are going to fall. But I'm just rubbing out those initial lines for where that armor is, just so that I can make these straps actually run a bit longer, because I didn't think that they were long enough. So we're just sorting that out. And as usual, just adding that extra line to give it that a bit more three dimensionality. Just to make it look a bit more like this armor has a bit more dimension to it. So it's not just like a flat piece of card that isn't going to save his life at all. It looks like it's a bit thicker, there's a bit more padding inside it, and it might actually save his life if he ever came to use it. But I'd say that's that for those two straps, and we can just start to add in that like where it kind of zips up from in the middle. There's kind of like a rim, a seam, if you will. That just comes there, but then we can start to add in that curve of the straps now. So as I said, I'm just adding in the straps now, like where that arc is just falling, and it can meet over at the other side and there as well. And I mean, from that we can start to draw in the belt buckle once we've got this in place. But this is just like the basic guideline of where that belt buckle itself is going to fit, like slot into. And I mean, again, that's just going to be a rectangle shape. And I mean, there's the belt buckle, there's the belt buckle guideline pretty much right there, that squarish kind of thing. And due to it being like him being at an angle, the other side is going to be a bit obscured. It's not going to be as long as the other side. You're only going to see a tiny bit of it, and I mean that's where the other side of the strap is going to be popping out that I've just drawn there now. So I mean that's pretty much it for that side of the belt buckle. So, yeah. So now that we've got that in, we can just start to make the buckle itself a bit more three-dimensional. Once we've got this strap in, and I mean, this is just going to be like the bit that's like pulled, like on a belt. Here, you've got the strap, you've got that bit that like actually comes through the belt, and that's that there that I'm drawing in now. So I mean, yeah, again, just adding a secondary line to that to make it look a bit more three-dimensional again, a bit thicker. I mean, if it was a belt, then it would be thick like that. It's not just going to be like a flat piece of card again. So yeah, I mean, I'm just. Again, just getting the basic lines of this strap itself in, and then we can start to move on to the buckle. I mean, this strap isn't like really a hard material like a belt, like it's not leather or anything. It is kind of like the same kind of what his padding on that body armor would be, kind of like a cloth kind of material. So that's why we're getting wrinkles in that actual strap itself. Because I mean, you wouldn't get wrinkles in a belt usually, but this isn't an actual belt. But I'd say that's basically it for the strap itself. I mean, we can start moving on to the buckle now. And as I said before, that strap is just like popping underneath the armour and just secures itself on the other side. But now we can start to, again, like I say, add a bit more three-dimensionality to it and get that buckle in. So we're just getting the shape of that in, and getting that edge where the hook in the belt itself is just going to pop out. That's where it's coming out now, and it's just going to hook into the strap itself, which we're doing now. And I mean that's basically it for the strap, well the strap that we're drawing on there. I mean it's just simple rectangle shape, as I said before, just following that simple arc that we drew in earlier. And I mean we can start to get, like I say, we've got the buckle in already, and we're just making that seam a bit thicker. But I mean it's the same principle for the top one as well. The top strap is just going to have simple rectangle and a belt buckle. It's going to be at a slightly different angle due to like that, due to the placement of it, because like we're kind of looking up at him, at Gaara, which is a good pose in my book, because he looks like he's going to judge you with his hand out, reaching out, or he's going to save you, maybe. Although in this pose he's going to look a bit more angry, to be honest, and with the sand that's going to be wrapping around himself, he's gonna look pretty pissed. Well, not really, not menacingly angry, just like, what'd you do that for? That kind of look. But yeah, as I say, that's pretty much it for the strap. So I can just get the other strap in now and come back and draw the face. I'm not gonna bother drawing the gourd, because the gourd, well, I'm not going to bother showing the drawing the gourd because it's just going to be two basic circles pretty much, which is easy enough to understand. But I'll come back and show you the details of the gourd. Alright, so now that we've got the basic shape of the gourd done and one of the marks on the, like the symbols on the gourd, we're going to focus on the one that's going to be closest to us on the bottom right of the top gourd circle shape thing, because that's going to be the biggest one, so it's going to be closest to us and most visible. So basically I'm just starting out with getting the, basically just drawing in parallel lines to follow the actual shape of the gourd. So you can see that instead of doing like a straight line, it's like following the actual curve of the gourd, so that we like, so that the shape, the symbol that we're actually drawing on, looks like it's actually on the gourd itself. If we drew it as just a normal square, then it looked quite odd and wouldn't look like it's actually on the gourd. It looked quite flat and ruined the effect of the actual three-dimensional ness of the gourd itself. Something like that. But basically, you can see that it's just simple rectangle at the moment, a curvy rectangle. It's basically just a rectangle that's on the gourd. So if you just follow those parallel lines, just making sure that like the top line of that rectangle is like parallel to the gourd bottle top thing, whatever that is, the opening. The bottom one's obviously parallel to the bottom, and the lines on the left are parallel to like what the gourd shape would actually look like, then you should be okay. And then just double those lines up so that you get like an edging of that rectangle. And then for the inner bit, it's basically the same, except we're just going to be like drawing a square to get that basic shape for the actual symbol, because the symbol kind of looks like an upside down M or a W, that kind of shape. But just by getting that square in first, we can kind of make it a bit easier on ourselves when we're drawing it. And I mean, you can see that I'm erasing quite a bit here. I've started it again because it's not perfect, and it still won't be perfect, but I do like to waste a bit of time, to be honest, because I mean, I'm sure that you've all noticed that my drawings take far too long, which is why these tutorials aren't that great, because I'm not actually like speaking about stuff that you might even need to know. I can only shove in tiny portions. Like for example, it probably would have been a good idea to show the details on how to do the clothing, or the basic shapes that I did, or the wrinkles, the hand, stuff that we've already like verged, is that the right word? Stuff that we've already like pushed through, we've just gotten straight past it. Well, I've just gone straight past it, and it might have been valuable information, but that's why I need to start drawing faster. And I mean, I'll get the hang of it eventually, but for now I'm really slow. So I wouldn't really call them tutorials, but yeah. If I did an actual tutorial, it'd probably be like 3 hours long. So, condense it into 30 minutes. So we're not really going to get much drawing time, to be honest. It's a lot of time lapse on probably the most important parts. And one of those things is actually the colours. So, like, let me know if you ever want a colour or an inking video. I don't see why you'd want an inking video, because like inking's just inking. You don't really need, there's nothing to learn on that. Just be careful, pretty much. It's dangerous as shit doing inking, so well, you might get these perfect pencil lines, but if you screw up on the inking, then you've ruined all that time that you spent doing the pencil lines. But anyway, getting back to the subject at hand, you can see that I've drawn that square now. It's just, well, it's kind of like a rhombus. It's a square pushed on its side. And we're just using that square so that we can get a more accurate symbol, which is just that upside down M or a W, which is more commonly known in the alphabet. But that's all there is to it, getting that shape, to be honest. The symbols are quite simplistic to do, and I mean, at the moment it's not looking its greatest. It's not really looking like the sticker's actually on there, but I'm probably just going to fiddle about with it a bit and like make those lines more accurate in a moment. Because, I mean, you can see that the edges of the W, the top bits, aren't actually parallel to that top line at all. So I'm just going to mess about with that in a bit. Just making everything a bit more parallel now. See? There we go. And now I can start to erase that and lengthen it a bit and make it a bit more parallel to that top line. And it starts to look a tiny bit better. So, as I say, yeah, I'll just mess about with it a bit. But yeah, like I was saying, I mean, if there's any, if you ever want an inking video, as needless and boring as it would be, or if you want a colouring video where I just talk through like the exact colours that I'm using, so that you, like, if you have those colours, then you'll know what to use. I mean, I'm not saying that you have to follow that colour set. By all means, I've probably got the colours absolutely wrong when I do start to colour this video. But I'm sure it does help to know, like, what colours to use, even if they do look wrong. It's good to have something to go off of. But anyway, now that I've got that symbol in, I'm going to jump into getting the bottom one done on the gourd and getting the cracks of the gourd sorted, and then we'll come back and do the face. Right, so just got the gourd sorted now, so I mean, I'm going to start to make a move on the face. So you can see that I've drawn two parallel lines here on the face going up at an angle, which is kind of just parallel to how his collar was before, because his face is kind of like, it's, he's looking at us more prominently with the one side of his face, if that makes sense. So obviously this eye that I'm drawing here is going to be the bigger of the two, whereas the other one you're only really going to see half or a third of the eye even on the other side, given that it's going to be diminished because the fact that he's looking at us at an angle with his face not looking straight forward in a three quarter view is what I'm trying to say. You're going to see this eye a lot more prominently than the other one. But you can see that I've just pretty much drawn like a diamond shape running across those parallel lines that I originally put in. I'm just doubling up those lines now because the signature of Gaara pretty much is his tattoo above his eye, and the fact that he's got these really, really thick eye lines, which is what I'm doing now by doubling up these lines. So now that I've done that, I can start to move on to the pupil. But already that doesn't look right because it looks like he's looking off to one side, whereas we do want him looking directly at us. So that's what I'm getting done now. So that already looks better because now he's looking more towards us, which is always good. I can just start to darken up some of these lines, and I mean the eyebrows are going to be a big part of this because we can make him look a bit more angry, as he usually does, because he's not all that happy a character. And I mean, I do want him to look like he's more in a battle pose than smiley. Gaara's known for how cool he is, and I think smile would ruin him. That's why I'm not going to follow the marks of my Metroid one and give him blushies, because if I did that, then it wouldn't look good at all. But yeah, I think you get the picture. Now that I've got this eye in place, I think I can get the other one done in time-lapse, so I'll get that done and we can come back and get the nose and the mouth in place. So now, as you can see, I've got both eyes in place and the pupils are looking in the same direction, which is always good, looking straight at you. If eyes could kill, you'd already be dead. But now we can start to move on to the nose, which is going to follow that curve of the eyebrow, really, and just you got the tip, obviously, and it's pointing towards the face, but his nose is looking a bit big there, and we don't want to give him a massive nose, because that's not one of the things that Gaara is known for. So I've just rubbed out that line, that like bit of the line that was joining the eyebrow and the nose, because we're only really using that as a guide. We don't want to go crazy and draw out all the defining features of his face, because it's just going to start to look less like Gaara and more like a humanoid creature who wants to be Gaara. So again, yeah, we're not being crazy with the nose, making it massive or anything, but we can start to get in the nostril. And so I'd say I need to mess about with the nostril a bit more. So I'll be honest, in terms of the mouth, it's just straight line, pretty much. So not really much to teach in terms of that. Just that I'd say that it's about 2/3 away from the chin and 1/3 away from the mouth. So that kind of thing you need to get right, because if it's too close to the chin, then it's going to look like he's pouting. And if it's too close to the nose, then he's going to look really, really weird. So I'd say that there, that's quite close to the nose, really. So, I mean, I'm probably going to have to rub that out in a bit. I mean, I'll try and mess about with it to make it work, but at the end of the day, if it's too close to the nose, then I'm going to have to rub that out, which I'd say it is, so I'm going to rub that out now. But basically, just messing about with it until it looks about right. So, I mean, pretty much that's it for the face, though. He's not really looking all too much like Gaara, but I'm hoping that once I get the face... once I get the face in... on top of the face that I've already drawn, apparently. Once I get the hair in, I'm gonna I hope that it looks more like Gaara. So I'm gonna get the hair in, the his tattoo. I'm not gonna come back and show you the pens, because by now it's probably got boring, and you should know what pens I use now. It's always the same ones, really. So I'm gonna get the inking done, I'm gonna get the colouring done, I'm gonna sign it, and add some sand in the background as well. So I'm gonna get everything done in time lapse, and I'll come back and just speak about it and say thanks. Okay, so that is how I draw Gaara of the Sand from Naruto Shippuden, if you'd like. Sorry about the awful pronunciation, but it's the best I got. So I got through quite a bit there, got all the colouring done, all the inking done, I got the sand done in the background, which obviously you didn't see me draw, but I mean, I didn't draw that in pencil, really. I just did wavy lines all over the place to get like a basic shape. I didn't ink it, I just went and coloured it along those lines to try and see what it would look like, and it came out pretty good, which I'm happy about. But basically, I understand that we didn't really get to do much, and if you want a colouring video, just ask, honestly, because I do have the videos spare, so I can always just come back and do a colouring video so that you guys can be like, oh, so that's how it's coloured. Because I'm quite happy with how it's been coloured and drawn, and I'm quite happy with this one, to be honest. But yeah, if you want anything done, like any other drawings, then just ask, just put in the comments what you'd like to see, and I will attempt to get it done. I'll try and make the tutorials better as always. So I'm going to keep trying to make them better, but it'll take some time, but hopefully they get better in time. But yeah, so I just want to end this with thanking you for watching. Thanks for everything, guys, subscribing, liking, commenting, watching's good. Thanks a lot, guys, and I will see you later.